This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Dear students, in the previous video lecture, I talked about atomic mass. I talked about gram atomic mass. I talked about gram atom, mole, molar mass, molecular mass, gram molecular mass, gram molecule. In that video lecture, I told you that atomic mass tells us that how many times an atom is heavier than 1/12th mass of carbon 12. For example, if I take oxygen atom, what is the atomic mass of oxygen? 16. It means oxygen is 16 times heavier than 1/12th mass of carbon 12 isotope. Gram atomic mass. Gram atomic mass is that much quantity of the element whose mass in gram is numerically equal to its atomic mass. For example, for oxygen, if I say gram atomic mass of oxygen, numerically I will write this as 16 and unit I will write as gram. And this gram atomic mass is same as 1 gram atom of oxygen. 1 gram atom of oxygen, or you say 1 mole of O. 1 mole of O, that is 16 gram. So this is also the molar mass of O. Now, molecular mass. Molecular mass, in a similar manner, it tells us that how many times a molecule is heavier than 1/12th mass of carbon 12 isotope. For example, H2SO4, the molecular mass of H2SO4, summation of atomic masses, it comes 98. It is 98 times heavier than 1/12th mass of carbon 12 isotope. Gram molecular mass is actually molecular mass expressed in grams. So I'll write 98. Numerically it is same as molecular mass, and the unit here is gram. And this gram molecular mass, is same as 1 gram molecule of H2SO4. 1 gram molecule of H2SO4, or you say 1 mole of H2SO4. So, this 98 gram is also the molar mass of H2SO4. The molar mass of H2SO4. Dear students, please note that there is no difference between atomic mass and atomic weight. In the same manner, there is no difference between molecular mass and molecular weight. At atomic level, the gravitational force is negligible. Now, in this chapter, I'll start my discussion with the term mole. And after that, I will talk about the mass mole number convergence. Mole. Mole is defined as the amount of the substance that contains as many specified elementary particles as the number of atoms in a 12 gram of carbon 12 isotope. In short, mole is just a number and the value is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. Please note, these particles can be atoms, can be molecules, can be ions, protons, electrons, neutrons, etc. And in the previous lecture, we also talked about the number of moles, how to find the number of moles. If the mass of the substance given, the mass must be in grams, and that mass divided by molar mass of the substance gives the number of moles of the substance. This word mole was introduced by Wilhelm Ostwald, and this word was derived from Latin word moles. The meaning of moles is heap or pile. In this formula, the mass is related with the number of moles. In 1811, Italian scientist Amedeo Avogadro related the volumes of gases with the number of moles and molecules. It is also known as Avogadro law. The law states that equal volumes of all the gases under the same conditions of temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecules. Equal number of molecules, we can also say equal number of moles. So if I try to find volume of 1 mole, volume of 1 mole gas, that we can call as molar volume. Molar volume. So under the same conditions of temperature and pressure, molar volume of all the gases will be same, right? Because if I take 1 mole of all the gases, means for all gases you are taking 1 mole, so the volume will also be the same according to the law. So this will help us, this molar volume will help us in finding the number of moles if the volume of the gas given. And that formula we can write, number of moles equal to volume of the gas, volume of the gas upon molar volume of the gas, molar volume of the gas. My point is clear. Now, I'll talk about 2-3 points here. Dear students, it has been found that the volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas at 1 atm and 273.15 Kelvin, that is 0 degree Celsius, is 22.4 liters. This we can say as molar volume under 1 atm and 273.15 Kelvin. Similarly, it has been found that the volume occupied by 1 mole of any gas at 1 bar, pressure is 1 bar, and temperature 273.15 Kelvin or 0 degree Celsius is 22.7 liters. I am telling you these two values because initially standard values of temperature and pressure were taken as 0 degree Celsius and 1 atm pressure. 0 degree Celsius or we can say 273.15 Kelvin. And this was referred as NTP, normal temperature and pressure. Later on, NTP was changed to STP, keeping the same values. But at present, STP means 273.15 Kelvin temperature and 1 bar pressure. Please note, 0 degree Celsius temperature and 1 bar pressure, while initially the pressure was 1 atm. So at present, if you are asked to write value of molar volume at STP, we should write what value? 22.7 liters. My point is clear. But the previous standard, that is 273.15 Kelvin temperature and 1 atm pressure, this standard is still often used in some exams and can be found in all problems and data which are more than decade old. And now this value can be used in finding the number of moles of the gas. So if volume of gas is given at STP, that volume must be in liter. That volume, if divided by 22.7, then we can get number of moles of the gas. My point is clear. Dear students, in many problems, mass of the substance will be given. Mass of the substance. And they may ask number of molecules, number of atoms, volume if it is gas. First, you convert the given mass into the number of moles. How will you convert this mass into number of moles? By dividing with molar mass. Now, number of moles can be converted into number of molecules. Number of molecules. How? We know 1 mole means 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. So, whatever moles we have with us, just multiply this Avogadro number. Now, number of molecules. Number of molecules can be converted into number of atoms. How? By multiplying the number of atoms present in one molecule. We have already got number of molecules. Multiply number of molecules with number of atoms in one molecule. One molecule. For example, if I take NH3, then this number will be 4. 3 plus 1. 3 hydrogen atoms, 1 nitrogen. If I take H2SO4, then the number will be 7. 2 hydrogen, 1 sulfur and 4 oxygen atoms. My point is clear. But in many cases, they will give you number of atoms and they will ask you number of molecules. Reverse. So what will you do? Just divide. Number of atoms will be divided with this 4 or 7, that is number of atoms in how many molecules? In one molecule. Now, molecules will be given and they may ask number of moles. What will you do? Here you have to divide Avogadro number. So, molecules will be divided with this Avogadro number to get number of moles. Now, how you convert moles into mass? Moles, when multiplied with molar mass, we get mass of the substance. Moles into mass. My point is clear. Now, many times they will give you volume of gas. Volume of gas and mainly at STP. So, how will you convert volume of gas at STP into number of moles? Volume upon 22.7. That volume must be in liter. So, if they give you volume of gas at STP and they ask you mass of the substance, first you convert volume into moles and then moles will be converted to mass by multiplying the molar mass. So, this way you can get the or you can convert volume into mass. Many times moles will be given and they will ask you volume. What will you do? Moles should be multiplied with 22.7 liters to get the volume of gas at STP. Now, if they give you mass of the substance and they ask volume, so first you convert mass into moles and then moles into volume. So this chart will help you in solving questions of mass, mole, number, volume conversions. My point is clear. For example, if I take 3.4 gram of NH3 and I try to find number of moles, number of molecules, number of atoms and volume of this NH3 at STP using this chart, then mass of NH3 given is 3.4 grams. So first I'll convert this 3.4 gram into number of moles. I'll use formula mass upon molar mass, and molar mass of NH3 is 17. So the value comes as 0.2. Now I'll convert number of moles into number of molecules. Number of molecules, and the value comes as 0.2. I'll multiply, how I get a number here, 6.022 into 10 raised to 23, and the value comes as 1.2044 into 10 raised to 23. Now, total number of atoms present in 3.4 gram of NH3 is, as we know, one molecule of NH3 has got 4 atoms. So I'll multiply this 4 in this 1.2044 into 10 raised to 23. Now, if we are asked to find only the number of hydrogen atoms, not the total number of atoms, then what number will you multiply? Now, 4 will not be multiplied, only 3 will be multiplied with the total number of molecules. My point is clear. If you are asked to find number of nitrogen atoms, then I'll multiply 1. Now, what will be the volume of NH3 gas at STP? We have already found the moles, so moles will be multiplied with 22.7 liters and this will give the volume of the gas at STP. So using chart, we can solve all these types of numericals very easily. In the next video lecture, I'll discuss the questions which can be framed with the help of these concepts. This video is presented to you by www.testprepadda.com. Testprepadda.com provides free audio-visual lectures of different subjects by expert faculties, free online tests prepared by expert faculties to students who are preparing for engineering or medical entrance exams or planning to take exams like KVPY, Olympiad, etc. It provides a platform where students can interact with mentors to improve their performance in the exams. The mission of this online medium is to help students to achieve their goals. Log on to www.testprepadda.com to watch free video lectures on different topics, to download free revision notes, to take free chapter-wise online tests, progressive test, and mock test, to discuss doubts with mentors. Thank you for watching the video. To stay up to date with the latest videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like us on our Facebook page, Test Prep Adda. All the best.